Hi, this is April, and I'm here at Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum in Denver, Colorado. Here in Denver, we're at 5,300 feet above sea level. What that means is that we have less air pressure here than we would have down at sea level. So at sea level, we have 14.7 pounds per square inch of air pressure pushing on our bodies all the time. Here in Denver, we have about 12 pounds per square inch pushing on our bodies. The reason I talk about that is because I want to show you what happens to the human body when we have less and less air pressure pushing on us until the point that we can't survive any longer. So here I'm going to take this marshmallow peep and I'm going to show you what would happen if you were going to go up high into Earth's atmosphere or into space without a suit on. So I'm going to take this little marshmallow peep here and I'm going to send it up high into Earth's atmosphere by putting it in a bell jar here where I'm going to take away the air pressure. So what you'll see when I turn this on and there's no more air pressure pushing on this peep is that this peep here starts to expand. This would be you if you didn't have a suit on or if you weren't in a space capsule. Now, this marshmallow peep won't stay big forever, and neither would you. And that's because the peep has a lot of little pores where the air would leak out. The air would also leak out of your body. Actually, it would only survive for about 90 seconds. So what you'll see here is that the peep is starting to shrink back down as all the air pressure leaves its body. Air pressure is also gone from the outside of the peep. So it's at an equilibrium, but not one that you would be able to survive. So when I bring you back down to normal air pressure, and here in Denver, we have about 12.06 pounds per square inch pushing on our bodies. Again, we don't normally feel it unless all the air is outside of our body. So when I reintroduce air to this container, what you'll see is that same air pressure that we didn't feel just a minute ago would crush us. So this is what would happen to you if you were going to go up high into Earth's atmosphere or out into space without a suit on. To show you how this works, I have another peep that's also inside a bottle right here, and I'm going to take a fresh peep and send it up. The peep that's in here, once I take all the air out again, is not going to expand while the other one does. And that's because it's in a fully enclosed container. The air pressure is still inside that bottle with the lid on, but yet there's no air pressure on this other peep, allowing it to expand. Again, this would be you without a suit on, and this would be you with a suit on. We'll take you back down to normal air pressure, and you will see that this peep is fully intact while this one has been crushed by the air pressure. So this is what happens to you without your suit on. Now, that's not the only thing that happens because you're also made up of a lot of water. So here I have a bottle of water. It's just at regular room temperature. You are mostly 3/4 water. So what happens to the water in your body if we go up without a spacesuit on or without any kind of pressure is that you'll see this water here in a minute starting to boil. Right now, water doesn't boil at room temperature because there's air pressure pushing down on it, keeping it from boiling. Typically, when we boil water, we add heat to the bottom, which increases its energy, right? Allowing it to overcome the air pressure. However, if we just take away the air pressure, keeping it from boiling, what you'll see is that water has enough energy inside it to boil on its own. This would be all the water inside of your body if you were to go above about 55,000 feet, which is known as Armstrong's line, all the water in your body would boil. Now, it's not getting hotter. It's actually using its own internal heat in order to boil, which means it's actually cooling off. So if you were going to go up into space or high into the atmosphere without a suit on, you would puff up. The water in your body would start to boil until it cooled down enough that you froze, and then you would crush when you come back down into Earth's atmosphere. So what you'll see here is that this water is not hot at all. It's actually a little cooler than when we started. Now, by simply putting a suit on, and in this case, we're just putting a lid on the bottle, one with a lid, one without a lid, and we'll send them back up high into the atmosphere once more, and you will see that the one with the lid on, which still has air pressure inside it, will not boil, whereas the one without the lid will boil just like you saw before. And here you see the boiling going on with the one without the lid, and you'll see that the one with the lid that still has air pressure inside is not boiling. So this is why high altitude pilots and astronauts always wear a suit or exist in a fully contained pressurized capsule when they go high into up into Earth's atmosphere or up into space. Thanks for watching.
Thanks very much for watching. You know, we've got a lot of really great artifacts in this museum, and we can hardly wait until the time comes when we can open our doors again and you can come and see them in person. Until that time, we're going to be working very hard to bring you new content, new demonstrations, new workshops, all kinds of wonderful things for you to watch on video. We're really dedicated to our mission of educating and inspiring people of all ages about the aerospace endeavors of the past, present, and future. If you like what you've been seeing, and if you want to support our museum, please follow the link below and make a donation. And thank you. Thank you very much.